Hey everyone, Bruce Smith here with GEOGRAPH. So we get asked all the time, how do you model distributed split architecture in CrescentLink? So I just want to take a few minutes, go through a quick video with you, show you how we manage and model a distributed split architecture within CrescentLink. So first off, let's talk about what is a distributed split architecture. So that is where you have your optical switch or your OLT located at your wire center, substation, central office, wherever that may be. You've got feeder fiber, which can be multiple strands of a fiber that go out to a location to a splitter. Typically, the first phase splitter is a 1x4 or even a 1x8 splitter. Then each one of the legs coming off of that splitter go to another splitter down a tap or out in the field. These again can be 1x4s or 1x8s. These can be any configuration of splitters and can be several layers deep. Right here I'm just showing kind of two layers deep, a 1 to a 4, and then that 1x4 feeding 4 1x4s, so on and so forth. But you get the idea to where this is taking the light that's coming off of the OLT per the per the specs, and it's breaking it down into multiple levels of splitter configurations into the field. This technique is used a lot of times to keep fiber cables small. Maybe you're running a fiber network on a power line, and you don't want to have large count fibers up there. You don't maybe have a lot of room for attachments. This is a good architecture to accommodate that. So let's jump in and take a look at how the tool manages that. Again, we're looking at the CrescentLink extension. I'm on version 5.1.4 here in Arc Desktop. I am also running, just for reference, Arc Desktop version 10.8. Again, CrescentLink is an extension that works on all releases of the Arc Desktop platform. So I'm just going to dock this window to get it out of the way, and we'll go through a scenario. So what I've got here is a central office, a fiber feeding out, and I'll show you where the two splitters are located. One of them is here on this pole at this location here in this splice case. We'll take a look at that. We'll just kind of dive into the CrescentLink manager here. Click on that splice case. It's going to pull up our dialog box here. Get that table of contents out of the way. And you can see I've got three splitters in here. I've got 3 1x8 splitters in this splice case. You can see the attributes of the splitter. You can see the feed on the splitter, and then the 8 ports coming out here on each one of these. You can see this one has another leg feeding off of that. And then this goes on and moves on down, and I believe the other splitter is right here at this location in line. So let's take a look at that. Just click on that. Yeah, we've got a 1x4 splitter here and a 1x4 splitter here. So we've got 2 1x4 splitters in this splice case as well. You can see the input here, and you can see the configuration there with the inputs and the outputs. All right, so let's go back to our central office, and we'll kind of run a scenario here. Where we want to find a customer. So we're going to start from the customer end and work back, show you how that works through the splitters, and then we'll go from the central office out. But if we wanted to find a customer in the network, we're going to go to our CrescentLink search tool here, and I'm just going to search for 105 College Street right here. And so we're going to zoom to that location, and you can kind of see it flashing there in the map. And so what I want to do is go ahead and use my CrescentLink Network Manager. I can click on the terminating location and see the address here, 105 College Street. We can see that it's a 2-port Calix 720G ONT. We have the account code, all of the attributes associated for this piece of electronics here. You can see the fiber cable coming in with the count associated with it. So we got a 2-strand fiber connecting that location. And then if we had any assignments, that would show up here as well, but I don't have any assignment information for that customer. But let's take a look at the equipment. So now we want to see how this connects back to the OLT or the line terminal back at the central office. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the port here that has the connection to the drop, and it's going to run a trace. And so I want to zoom to that trace here, and we can see that it goes from our 105 College Street address back through the cable all the way to the central office here. You can see it visually represented in this trace. What you get here is a dialog box kind of detailing that trace. So we originate at the Clemson central office. We're on a Calix E72 GPine 8-port, port 1 on that card here. We can see how it goes through the patch panel, through the cables, and then we get to our first splitter, which is right here. You can tell that by this little drop-down box here. So it comes in on splitter 1, and it goes out the back on port 1 of that 1x8 splitter. Goes through the cable again, comes to another splitter here that we saw, and it goes in on port on the input of this 1x4 splitter 1, and it goes out on port 3 of that splitter. So we can see that it's on the third leg of that 1x4 splitter. So it's going through two splitters here, so originating from the GPON port, going to splitter 1, to splitter 2, and then finally to the ONT here at 105 College Street. We also have the ability to right-click here, look at a design layout record, and see this trace also here in kind of a straight line or what we call a single line diagram. So from the office here, the GPON port, the patch panel that it goes through in the central office, the connections to the first splitter. So we see it's on splitter 1, coming in on port 1, and then going out on port 1. So it's on the first leg of that 1x8 splitter. That's feeding down to splitter 1 here at this splice case, 1x4. So it's coming in on the input, going out on port 3, and then going to the OLT here. We can see that it's a fully lit circuit because it's coming out of an active GPON, going to an active OLT by these, you can tell that by these highlighted green colors here. And we see that it goes approximately 2,567 feet. Now, if we wanted to come in here and add, a scenario where we had to add a drop, let's say we're going to add a drop to this location here, we would simply come in here, go to our SEO or our drop cable, connect it to our splice point there, to this splice point here, right-click and say Finish Sketch, all right? We want to come in here and make sure that our terminating location has an ONT, and so it does not. So I'm going to right click, and I'm going to go to a template because I have this saved. So we're going to go to and grab an ONT here. We could change or edit anything in here. So that is at 122 Elm Street. We're going to come in here and just say 122 Elm Street for the station ID. And we're going to edit the ports because this one just has one port. So we're going to have a front single, two port. Need to delete one of those. Got a little rambunctious there. So we got two ports, and we're going to say OK. All right. So now we've got our ONT created with the station ID. We have two ports, and we want to connect this to the drop we just did. So we're going to use our connector tool here. Click on that location again. Skip the step here. I did not put the size on this drop. So let's go to the attributes and assign a size of 2 strand fiber. We can put any other information or attributes that we'd like to in here. All right, so now we're going to go back to connector. Now we see our 2 strand fiber drop. So we're just going to click one there, say OK. Now we want to connect that to this 1x4 splitter that's in this location. So we're going to click on that one. We're going to go to the back of splitter 1, and so we have split 4 there, and so we're going to pick our 2-pair drop that goes to 122 Elm Street, which is right here. We're just going to connect that to there. So now we've got the 4th port of that splitter connected to the drop. And now we just kind of want to run a check and see, you know, is there anywhere else we need to make a connection here. And as we see, by our trace is going from 122 Elm Street, the ONT we just created, through the 1x4 splitter on split 4, It was already going through the eight, the 1x8 splitter, so that's good. We didn't have to go there and make a connection, and it's going all the way back to the central office on the GPON port. You can see that the trace is active because of the yellow fiber here. And if we zoom to that, we now see that we've got 122 Elm Street connected all the way back to the central office. And it's in there, part of our network from here on out. All right, so that's a quick rundown of how we use distributed or cascaded splits in the CrescentLink toolbar. Thank you for your attention. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.